Hey guys, how do you do? Welcome to Traditional Programming Wizards. This is Regia. Of course, this is our C# tutorial. Okay, our data grid view, Metro data grid view tutorial. We're going to see how to, of course, show render buttons in our data grid view and handle those particular button clicks. Okay, you can see, for instance, this is a multi-column grid data grid view right here. And then, of course, you can see we have our button column right here. For instance, if I can click my first button right here, you can see we are able to get the position you clicked 0. Okay, that's the first position for that particular button, actually the row index. If we come to the second one, you clicked 1. This of course is the second index right here, index 1. Okay, so you can see this right of course is our button, but our data grid view, our button column. Okay, this is of course what we are going to look at now. So go ahead, create our project. Once you've created your project, of course, let's come to our designer, form designer over right here. Of course, the first thing I'm going to assume is that as you can see, we have this nice UI framework, Metro framework that we're using. I'm assuming you've already installed it. Please, if you're not sure, we have our first episode that we did show step by step how to install actually Metro framework. Okay, you can see, for instance, some of the components that we're having. We're going to cover a majority of them. Now, if in case you had installed it, what will require you for these classes to come and then add the references. Okay, come right here, right click, then of course navigate over to where the project onto which we did install it. Okay, for me, you can see right here I'm having them. We have these particular DLLs right here. So go reference these particular DLLs, check them, then click OK to add them to our project. Once you've done that one, then of course, if you rebuild your project, you are going to be able to drag components to and from, of course, our form right here. The first thing, the only component I require you guys to drag to your form is our data Metro grid. So come right here. We're using the Metro grid. Okay, so come drag the Metro grid. By the way, if you have Metro framework, this tutorial can also apply to just the ordinary WinForms. Okay, it's actually the same thing, everything, all this particular code is only that your UI won't be like this one. So please do that one, then of course we move over to our code. Now the first thing in our form right here, okay, let's come right here and then just make it to derive from the Metro form. If you do so, if you come to your form right here, you're going to be seeing this is our Metro theme. Okay, then of course just click your data grid view, then go to the properties section. Now inside our events right here, we're going to come and then override our cell click event. So double click it right here, then of course we're going to handle this particular M data grid cell click. So of course, if there's a selects this one, let's just come right here. So what before we, okay, the first thing of course we're going to do inside our constructor, of course by default our initialize components method shall get called. Then of course we're going to call the set colon methods, it's our custom method. Then of course we add data, then of course we add our button columns. So first let's come come right here to our, of course, set columns method. This particular method is going to be actually pretty simple. What we're going to do right here is just set our data grid view columns. So the first, of course, we specify the total number of columns we're going to have. Now for us, we're going to have 3 columns. So m data grid dot column count equal to 3. Then of course we specify the column headers. For instance, m data grid dot columns right here. This is going to give us an array. We index reference the first item in that particular array, of course, dot name is name property, we assign it to this one. Then of course the propellant, the second destination, the third. Then we come right here, m data grid dot set dot auto size columns mode equal to data grid view auto size columns mode dot fill. This is going to ensure that our rows, actually our columns, are actually going to fill, of course, the whole of the data grid view, okay, without leaving these spaces. So we come, the next thing we're going to come with here inside our event handler mdata grid cell click. That is if the user clicks any item, any cell in our data grid view, what are you going to do? Well, of course, we're going to come right here. If e dot colon index equal to 3, what we're looking for, we're looking for right here the fourth column in our data grid view. Okay, so column index, the column index number 3 right here. Okay, if e dot column index equal to number 3, that is actually we want the our button column. If that is clicked, then of course we're going to show message box, metro message box to show this you clicked e dot row index to get the current row index for that particular, of course, button that's been clicked. Okay, next we're going to come our add button method right here. The first thing we're going to do is to instantiate our data grid view button column, data grid view button column btn equal to new data grid view button column. Then of course we set its properties. First, use column text for button value. All right, now the column text, of course, in the buttons, those are what we're going to use as the button values. Then btn.header text, btn.name, then btn.text. These are just properties for our data, our button column. Then of course mdatagrid.columns.add, we add this particular button column, of course, to our columns collection in our data grid view. Next, we're going to come to our add data. All right, first, of course, we're going to create a string array that we're calling row. It has by default 3 columns. Okay, of course, actually we add our data right here, Cassini chemical, and then of course the Saturn right here. So of course Cassini, this is going to respond, it's going to actually correspond to the spacecraft name. The chemical right is going to correspond to the column, actually our propellant column. Then of course our Saturn right here is going to correspond to our destination column. Next, we're going to add that particular row to our rows collection, mdatagrid.rows.add row. Okay, then of course we go ahead, reinstantiate our row array, reinitialize it of course with our data. Then of course we add it to our collection. We do the same thing for more of our rows right here. Okay, so for us, we're going to have these 1 2 3 4 5 rows by default. These are add data method. Guys, it's actually going to be responsible for filling, populating our data grid view of course with our data. Okay, that's it guys, that's it for this particular class. Is this simple? All right, we can now just run the project and see of course what we have. Now of course if we run the project, this is what we're getting. You can see we have our data right here of course, and our buttons. If I click for instance let's say this one, you can see you clicked 3. Okay, that is our fourth index, index 3 right there for of course our fourth row of course in our data grid view. If I come right here, you clicked 0, which of course is our first index. Okay, this is it guys, this is what we've looked at. Okay, our data grid view tutorial. I'm hoping you guys have enjoyed the tutorial. If you have, like the video, share it. Also make sure that you subscribe. We normally do post a lot of C# classes, so you don't want to miss them out. Okay, take care, I'll catch you in the next